After recreational marijuana was legalized in California on October 30th, 2017, Palo Alto City Council unanimously voted to continue the prohibition of marijuana dispensaries within city limits. Only two council members, Corey Wolbach and Adrian Fine, supported a more lenient approach towards dispensaries in Palo Alto.
On January 1st, this will be a completely legal local retail business. Some of these businesses have helped certain neighborhoods and districts come back to life.
I think it should be legal in California, but I don't want to see it in Palo Alto.
To have it sold and have a dispensary, I think it's just a little bit too much for the city to bear at this time and take on.
Yes, we'll just reflect that the vote is. So that passes unanimously.
The Paly Voice sat down with Councilman Fine to discuss City Council's decision. Currently, no medical marijuana dispensaries are legal in Palo Alto.
So in Palo Alto last October, we decided to take a look at our regulations about that and figure out how we want to regulate those uses. So I think it's, there's, you know, growing it, distributing it, manufacturing, and then distribution, actually like sale. And the city council declined to actually do anything there. So at the current time in Palo Alto, adults over 21 can possess cannabis. They can use it in private facilities, at home and things like that. They can use delivery services, both I think on the web and phone, things like that. But at the current time, you know, facilities to actually process, to grow, or to sell cannabis are banned in Palo Alto.
However, other Bay Area cities are exploring the idea.
I think, and I said this at the council meeting in October, that we've been a little conservative on that. A few other cities have gone ahead and instructed their staff to figure out laws and regulations to begin allowing a certain number of cannabis businesses in the right locations. So some cities such as Mountain View, Santa Clara, San Jose, San Francisco, Oakland, have got regulations on the books or are writing them right now to allow cannabis businesses that would either, you know, grow the product on site, would potentially sell it, or be in the manufacturing business. One of the reasons Mountain View actually did it also was for sales tax uses. So local jurisdictions are allowed to tax the products, and some of them are taxing up to 45%, which means they can be a large new revenue source for other city services that we provide.
Palo Alto City Council members want to approach this issue carefully.
I think there were a few things that my fellow council members were concerned about. One is they were interested in seeing what other communities did first, right? Let's stand back and look at what Mountain View does. Let's go see what Sunnyvale does. Let's see how it proceeds in San Jose. You know, a few council members brought up the issue of, you know, gangs, violence, and, you know, marijuana use by children. And to, like, be absolutely clear in this, speaking to you all, like, look, smoking too much dope makes you dumb and demotivated, right? Like, there's no question about that. Kids, if they want to get marijuana, like, they're going to get it, right?
Adrian Fine described why he feels city council should re-examine the subject.
Nonetheless, like, you know, we've said in this state that it's legal now. And just like alcohol, which, you know, causes alcohol poisoning and can cause death, we have said that adults can make that choice. And, you know, with 66% of Palo Altans voting to legalize cannabis in the state, I thought it would be fair for us to at least explore how we could have, you know, one or two dispensaries on our main commercial areas.
At a high level, I think our city is being a bit too tepid and overly conservative on this. And since Palo Alto voters did overwhelmingly support this change in law, I think it's incumbent upon us to follow that and at least give a good try at figuring out some way where we could incorporate cannabis commercial businesses in our city.
There are some worries that having a dispensary is kind of like a magnet. You know, these places are pretty secure. They are required to have security, check ID, all that kind of stuff. So it's kind of similar to buying alcohol that, like, yes, there may be some rare exceptions where an underage person can access it, but that's illegal now, right?
Mr. Fine thinks that in the future, it would be possible to see medical marijuana dispensaries in Palo Alto.
I don't think it's crazy to imagine having one or two dispensaries on University, maybe Cal Ave, where Palo Altans or tourists or people who work here, you know, go and stop by and treat it kind of like a wine bar, actually. You know, that's what has been happening in places like Oakland and San Jose and Amsterdam for a very long time. Now that this use is legal in California, I think we should begin to treat it as something that's legitimate in terms of what kind of businesses we have in our cities, in terms of something that generates sales tax. A lot of folks nowadays are worried about brick and mortar retail stores going away to Amazon. This is something that actually can't be replaced by Amazon. And so we need to think about it kind of as a bricks and mortar addition to our city. That's where I'd like to see it go. You know, for the time being, we put the kibosh on it, but, you know, maybe in a couple of years we'll revisit it and figure out what other cities have done and how we might be able to regulate cannabis dispensaries in Palo Alto.
For the Paly Voice, I'm Finn Minuti.